Right now is a very interesting company, not least of which because it's a fast-growing technology company in Bozeman, Montana. Now, that's not the place where you usually find these kinds of companies, but you got to go a long way to find companies that just do software as a service. So if you look at the sales growth of that company, you can see that it's not only are sales growing rapidly, it's an increase in the rate of sales. So that when you look at that chart, you really see why the market gets so excited about it and why the stock is going up so much, sales rising from 15 to 24% growth year over year. That kind of accelerating sales growth gets Wall Street very excited. But there are issues with that growth, not least of which the cost of marketing. If you look at the percentage of that sales that goes right into sales and marketing, it's a big number and it's stubbornly high. 42% 6 quarters ago, still 43%, and the company said it's going to hire even more salespeople and put more of that effort into it. What that results in is a company whose free cash flow can be quite anemic at times, because when the company's spending so much on sales and marketing and all this other junk, you have very little cash left over. If you look at the free cash flow of right now, what you see is not a lot of money is coming back in free cash flow right now. If you look at that chart in the last quarter in particular, but even if you go back to Q4, Q3 of 2010, $4 million when a company's doing something like $50 million a quarter is not a lot of free cash flow to have left over at the end of the day. And when it's less than $400,000, that's particularly weak. The last thing I want to show you is maybe the most important thing to understand the stock, and that's a chart of an entirely different company, right across the street here, Salesforce.com, a market darling by any other measure. This is the company to which right now is most often compared to in the market. Investors are trying to find the next Salesforce.com. Right now, it's just the next right now. It's not the next Salesforce.com, but it's what gets the market so excited about this company. Emily?
And joining us now is right now CEO Greg Gianforte. Greg, thanks so much for joining us here on Bloomberg West. So before we go further, can you give us an example of what you guys do? You basically help brands manage their relationship with customers.
That's right. And that's really a distinctive for us. We focus on large enterprises and particularly organizations that have lots of consumers. And we help them deliver better experiences to their customers. And we do that about 8 million times a day, making us one of the 100 largest websites in the world.
Now, what's it like taking on the giants like Salesforce and Oracle?
Well, we've always had a focus on the external interactions between large consumer businesses and their clients. That's very different than the focus that Oracle or someone like Salesforce.com has. And it's that focus that gives us real advantage. Just recently here, we announced that we won all the business at Yahoo to help them with all their client interactions. That was a competitive deal. All the suspect vendors were there, but we won because we have capabilities that they don't.
Well, let me explain it more. I always think it's just customer service software, but I don't see why that's actually software as a service. It's just customer service software, isn't it?
Well, we do a lot more than traditional customer service. Customer service software historically, CRM software historically, has really been only about what goes on inside the business in front of an agent and the contact center. Our focus is on the external interactions, whether they occur over the web, over mobile devices, in social channels. It's much more about the external focus. And again, it's a B2C focus as opposed to a B2B focus where CRM historically
is
focused.
Well, let me talk about this a little bit, because I talked about your free cash flows, and you were next to me as I was talking about your crummy free cash flow, and you were sort of nodding your head. When does this business start to throw off the free cash flow that a software company should?
Yeah, we're really proud of the top line growth we've had, up 24%
right,
year over year.
At the end of the day, it's all about free cash flow.
Right. So, we're at a point of inflection this year in cash flow, in large part because about a year and a half ago, we changed our contract with our customers from a 2-year agreement paid up front to a 3-year agreement paid annually. And that's a flywheel that starts to kick in the beginning of next year.
So you're going to see a big change of free cash flow this year?
That's what our CFO has communicated to Wall Street in prior analyst briefings.
Well, what's your take then? We heard Corey's take. What's your take on why the stock has gone up so much? I mean, what do you attribute the success to?
Yeah, there's a couple of things that are really driving the business. I mean, we all know that as consumers, the internet's really given us a lot more power. And large corporations, the only way they can differentiate in their markets is by providing a better customer experience. We're benefiting from that. We're certainly also benefiting from the adoption of the cloud. It's also the case that there's an awful lot of Oracle Siebel installations that went in 10 years ago that are really expensive and hard to maintain, and we're benefiting from a replacement cycle in that sector. So it's those three things together that are really giving us the tailwind.
What about the issue of security in the cloud? Obviously, that's becoming a much bigger concern. We were speaking with CEO Mark Benioff Salesforce CEO Mark Benioff the other day, and he said that is the seminal question.
Yeah. So this is an area we've really led because more than 60% of our business comes from organizations that have more than $1 billion in revenue themselves. We've solved many of the problems of security in large enterprise, and particularly with government, because in government, we're the only cloud applications company to have a multi-tenant capability installed for the Department of Defense according to the DIACAP standards. Now, kind of technical, but we're kind of out on the leading edge here in helping government.
Let me ask you about sales. We just heard from Adobe. Adobe said U.S. sales were disappointing, or at least that was the interpretation of what their low sales in U.S. sales. You guys are hiring more salespeople aggressively and changing your sales staff. What gives you the confidence right now, pun fully intended, right now that the business is going to be there to support an increased sales staff?
Well, we've seen great growth this past year, 24% up year over year. We're investing into the opportunity we see in the marketplace.
But what do you see right now?
Well, you know, in our client base, we have about 2,000 clients. There's massive opportunity in our install base, about an opportunity to increase revenue by 5x just with our existing products, with our existing clients. In addition, there's about 6,000 organizations just in North America and Europe that are in the same verticals we've already sold to that we haven't sold to yet. And that's just a greenfield opportunity for us.
Corey's the first person to crack that right now joke, right?
Yeah, I've heard it before.
He's a funny guy. All right, Greg Gianforte, CEO of RightNow Technologies. Thanks so much for joining us.